Our lessons this morning present the glorious hope of the Christian in contrast to this troubled world. In the Old Testament lesson, God states His intention of creating a new heaven and a new earth in which His blessings, we, His children, will enjoy. In particular, He contrasts it with the often sorrowful life experienced in this world. The Old Testament lesson is written in the 65th chapter of Isaiah, beginning at the 17th verse. "Behold, I will create new heavens and a new earth. The former things will not be remembered, nor will they come to mind. But be glad and rejoice forever in what I will create. For I will create Jerusalem to be a delight and its people a joy. I will rejoice over Jerusalem and take delight in my people. The sound of weeping and of crying will be heard in it no more. Never again will there be in it an infant who lives but a few days, or an old man who does not live out his years. He who dies at 100 will be thought a mere youth. He who fails to reach 100 will be considered accursed. They will build houses and will dwell in them. They will plant vineyards and eat their fruit. No longer will they build houses and others live in them, or plant and others eat. For as the days of a tree, so will be the days of my people. My chosen ones will long enjoy the works of their hands. They will not toil in vain or bear children doomed to misfortune. For they will be a people blessed by the Lord, they and their descendants with them. Before they call, I will answer. While they are still speaking, I will hear. The wolf and the lamb will feed together, and the lion will eat straw like the ox. But dust will be the serpent's food. They will neither destroy nor harm on all my holy mountain, says the Lord. But thou, O Lord, have mercy upon us." Peter assures us from his first epistle that in spite of opposition and mocking we will meet in this life, we can be certain of Christ's return. Trust Him. Be patient. Joyfully await His great return. The epistle lesson for this, the last Sunday of the church year, the Sunday of the fulfillment, is written in the epistle of Peter's second epistle, the third chapter, beginning at the third verse. "First of all, you must understand that in the last days scoffers will come, scoffing and following their own evil desires. They will say, 'Where is this coming He promised?' Ever since our fathers died, everything goes on as it has since the beginning of creation. But do not forget this one thing, dear friends. With the Lord, a day is like 1,000 years. And 1,000 years are like a day. The Lord is not slow in keeping His promise, as some understand slowness. He is patient with you, not wanting anyone to perish, but everyone to come to repentance. But the day of the Lord will come like a thief. But in keeping with His promise, we are looking forward to a new heaven and a new earth, the home of righteousness. But thou, O Lord, have mercy upon us." Please rise for the reading of the Holy Gospel. From the Holy Gospel is our Lord's parable of the wise and foolish virgins. The wise find acceptance because they are ready. The foolish, however, are shut out because they were not prepared. The Holy Gospel is written in the 25th chapter of St. Matthew, beginning at the first verse. Jesus said, "At that time the kingdom of heaven will be like 10 virgins who took their lamps and went out to meet the bridegroom. 5 of them were foolish, and five were wise. The foolish ones took their lamps, but did not take any oil with them. The wise, however, took oil in jars along with their lamps. The bridegroom was a long time in coming, and they all became drowsy and fell asleep. At midnight, the cry rang out, "Here is the bridegroom. Come out to meet him." Then all the virgins woke up and trimmed their lamps. The foolish one said to the wise, "Give us some of your oil. Our lamps are going out." "No," they replied, "there may not be enough for both us and you. Instead, go to those who sell oil and buy some for yourselves." But while they were on their way to buy the oil, the bridegroom arrived. The virgins who were ready went in with him to the wedding banquet, and the door was shut. Later, the others also came. "Sir, sir," they said, "open the door for us." But he replied, "I tell you the truth, I don't know you. Therefore, keep watch, because you do not know the day or the hour. But thou, O Lord, have mercy upon us.